Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast, war in Artsakh as a way to avoid the application of the Treaty of Sevres. Interview with the culturologist Karine Hakobyan. The UN assessment mission is going to arrive in Artsakh. Restoration works continue in Artsakh. The US military budget for 2021 envisages sanctions against Turkey. The main exhibition of the Matenadaran Museum Complex will reopen on December 8. In a conversation with Western Armenia TV, the President of the Republic of Western Armenia, Armen Akabramian, spoke about the resolution on Artsakh passed by the French Senate and then by the overwhelming majority in the parliament. Armen Akabramian expressed his opinion on the results of these votes. After all the debates in the Senate and the discussions in the parliament, as well as after the answers of the President and the government, I realized how France managed to bypass the issue of the Treaty of Sevres to ratify and implement it on Centenary Day during the Artsakh War. The scenario is best elaborated. Artsakh is now paying the price of Turkey's international defense, although Azerbaijan and Armenia have endangered most of their state sovereignty. It is obvious to any specialist that the recognition of Artsakh in international law can be effective only if Western Armenia decides to legally secede from it. I repeat that Artsakh has been an integral part of Armenia since 1920, so the Soviet legislation, which was applied even at that time to the detriment of Armenia today, has no force of law. Exceptionally, by law, the borders of Turkey and Azerbaijan begin where the borders of Western Armenia end, where the door remains open for genocide, ethnic cleansing, worse, until the complete extermination of the Armenian identity. This scenario of French recognition of Artsakh, which is to the detriment of the ratification of the Treaty of Sevres and its application centennial, was planned and staged by the same people who declared themselves defenders of the Armenian issue in 1987 and 2001. This is stated in Article 2 of the European Parliament Resolution on a Political Solution to the Armenian Question. Article 2, the tragic events in 1915-1917 involving the Armenians living in the territory of the Ottoman Empire, constitute genocide within the meaning of the Convention of the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide adopted by the UN General Assembly on December 9, 1948. The article recognizes, however, that the present Turkey cannot be held responsible for the tragedy experienced by the Armenians of the Ottoman Empire, and stresses that neither political nor legal or material claims against present-day Turkey can be derived from the recognition of the historical event as an act of genocide. The full interview is available on our website. In a conversation with Western Armenia TV, culturologist publicist Karine Hakobyan presented the term of general culture policy and its theory, referring to the development of world cultural policy and its vision in Armenia. She mentioned the importance of the national culture, its preservation and development prospects in the Republic of Armenia. She talked about the cultural heritage left in Western Armenia, their attempts by nomadic tribes to present themselves, and etc. She referred in detail to the foreign policy of culture, film critics, literary critics, and the works of other cultural spheres. The UN mission is going to leave for Artsakh to assess the humanitarian situation in the region. As reported by TASS, this was stated by the official representative of the Russian Foreign Ministry, Maria Zakharova. The International Committee of the Red Cross is operating in the region, and the United Nations Comprehensive Planning and Performance Assessment Mission is going to leave, she said. According to Zakharova, the Russian side is in close contact with the relevant Armenian and Azerbaijani structures in the settlement of humanitarian issues, as well as works with interested international organizations. The Interdepartmental Center for Humanitarian Response is developing its support for refugees returning to their former places of residence in Artsakh. The number of those who returned from November 14 is approaching 30,000. 1,000 to 2,000 people are transported daily. Measures taken for the delivery of humanitarian aid have begun too, she said. In almost all settlements of Artsakh, the buildings damaged as a result of war are being restored. The Artsakh Minister of Urban Development informs about this. Restoration works of educational buildings, apartments, roofs and houses damaged by the war continues. In the first stage, the installation of roofs, doors, windows is being carried out. In the second stage, the interior constructing works will begin. The provision of construction materials to the residents for the restoration of the damaged houses is underway too. In rural areas of Artsakh, which have not been inhabited for many years and have been provided to evacuated families, restorations are also being carried out. The U.S. draft defense budget for 2021, which was approved by both houses of Congress, envisages the imposition of sanctions on Turkey for the purchase of Russian S-400 anti-aircraft missile systems. No later than 30 days after the entry into force of this law, the U.S. president must impose 5 or more restrictions on anyone involved in the acquisition of S-400 systems, the draft states. The United States has repeatedly expressed concern over Turkey's acquisition of S-400 because it was believed Russia could use the systems to obtain information on the fifth-generation F-35 fighter jets. However, official Ankara insisted that the acquisition of S-400 systems is not a political but a purely military issue. The main exhibition of the Matenadaran, which is both a museum of ancient manuscripts and a scientific research institute after Mesrop Mashtots, will be reopened on December 8. The message published on the official Facebook page of Matenadaran says the visitors can watch the exhibits from Tuesday to Saturday. The exhibition complex of Matenadaran now consists of 12 exhibition halls, in which hundreds of exhibits are presented, intended for permanent, temporary, exclusive exhibitions. Out of about 20,000 manuscripts of Matenadaran, complete manuscripts, fragments of manuscripts, documents, antique books, samples of expensive covers are displayed. Now let us represent your attention a song Nortzarik by Nerses Norhali. You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.